Hi, I am Catherine Hood. I'm a certified health and lifestyle coach, plus the founder of Power Up. So, do you suffer from frequent headaches, or do you track your headaches or even journal about them in a diary? I do recommend it. By tracking your headaches, especially any episodes that you might be having, you might find that it might be from specific foods that you're eating frequently. And that's where I come in. I have something special to offer you. Not only can specific foods trigger a headache, but dietary habits can also play a role. Things like fasting, maybe you're dehydrated or skipping meals, these all can cause headaches. Eating small meals frequently to learn how. You just need to join Power Up Premium. Enrollment is actually open right now, today, until the 7th, and the 1st through the 7th every single month. So feel free to comment below or send me a private message. Some of the most common food, beverage, and additives associated with headaches would include aged cheese. Did you know that? For people that do take antidepressants, really need to avoid aged cheese. They need to avoid red wine, alcoholic beverages, and processed meats. Alcohol can also cause migraines, and the reason is the blood flow to your brain increases when you drink alcohol. Some scientists blame the headaches on impurities in the alcohol or by byproducts produced as your body metabolizes the alcohol. Sulfates used as a preservative may also cause the headaches. The higher the sulfate content, the greater the chance of developing a migraine. So, alcohol can cause dehydration as well, which again can cause headaches. Red wine, beer, whiskey, scotch, and champagne are among the most commonly identified headache triggers. So, food additives, food preservatives, or additives contained in certain foods can also trigger headaches. Nitrates are in hot dogs, ham, sausage, bacon, lunch meats, and deli-style meats, pepperoni, other cured or processed meats. All right, so some heart medications can also cause migraines. If you're not aware, definitely talk to your doctor about it. That could be the cause. All right, so monosodium glutamate, most of you may know this as MSG, is a food additive or flavor enhancer that may trigger headaches as well. MSG is one of the active ingredients in soy sauce, meat tenderizer, Asian foods, and a variety of packaged foods. So be aware of labeling such as hydrolyzed fat or hydrolyzed protein or all natural preservatives, since these terms are actually a twist on MSG. So most symptoms begin within 20 to 25 minutes after consuming MSG, and they can include pressure in your chest, tightening and pressuring in your face, burning sensation in your chest, your neck, your shoulders, maybe some facial flushing or dizziness, headache pain across the front or the sides of your head, abdominal discomfort, and chills. So, other foods, these foods might be identified as triggers for some headache sufferers as well. And these are kind of the sad ones, if I may say so. peanuts, which actually are not nuts at all, but peanuts, peanut butter, almonds, and other nuts and seeds. Pizza and other tomato-based products are also common to cause headaches. Potato chip products are also super common. Chicken livers and other organs are really common, like pate. I'm sure most of you don't eat pate too often, but smoked or dried fish can cause headaches. Pickled foods like, pickles, olives, sauerkraut, sourdough bread, and fresh baked yeast goods such as donuts, cake, homemade breads, and rolls also can cause headaches. Brewer's yeast found in all natural supplements can also be a trigger. Bread, crackers, and desserts containing cheese, of course. Most beans, including lima, Italian, broad, fava, navy, pinto, snow beans, garbanzo, lentils, dried beans, and peas are also real common at causing headaches. So, onions are probably another one too that are kind of mysterious and we put in a lot of our foods. Avocados are also known to be a trigger. Certain fresh fruits, including bananas, citrus, papaya, red plums, raspberries, kiwi, and pineapple. Dried fruit are also a really common irritant for headaches, and it might be something that's kind of getting snuck into your diet and you're not even realizing it. So things like figs, raisins, or dates. Soups made from meat extracts or bouillon can also cause headaches. Cultured dairy products, things like sour cream, buttermilk, and yogurt. So if your diet is consisting a lot of these things, and again, I told you it was all the fun stuff, it might be time to eliminate them for a period of time. And I'll tell you a little bit more about that in just a second. Caffeine is probably one that a lot of you probably already know or assume, but caffeine is also found in chocolate and cocoa products. Obviously your coffee, your teas, and your colas, and it can be in some over-the-counter or prescription medications. Small amounts may improve a migraine, but you need to limit to 200 milligrams a day, or that amount can be about a 10-ounce cup of coffee. Too much caffeine or large shifts in any kind of amount, up or down, consumed from one day to the next can cause a caffeine withdrawal and can provoke a headache. Aspartame and other artificial sweeteners are linked to headaches in some people as well. So some less common ones, and again, some of these are fun and I apologize, but to watch out for are bananas, right? Bananas. Beans, kind of mentioned that earlier. Chocolate, that's the caffeine again. Corn is another one that's probably a little bit sneaky and most of you are not aware of, but they can also trigger headaches. Citrus fruit also can trigger headaches, and it can trigger a lot of other things like joint pain. Cultured dairy products, talked about that a little bit earlier. Nuts and nut butters, onions, and tomatoes. I didn't really cover that one in depth, but tomatoes and peppers and eggplants also are well known for causing headaches. And you don't really think about that because that's the ketchup and that's your pasta sauces and your salsas. And yeah, so tomatoes are a culprit along with peppers. In conclusion, eat as much wholesome fresh foods like fruits and vegetables as you can. Avoid the processed packaged foods. So avoid the frozen section, all those things in those colorful boxes and stuff. There's a lot of sodium in them also, and they also contain a lot of these headache triggering ingredients. So eat more mini meals. So instead of 3 large meals a day or less, some of you are probably eating less, opt for 5 or 6 small meals a day. This will prevent you from getting headaches as well, because your blood sugar is maintained and you're not going from highs to lows and drastically going up and down all throughout the day. So that will help prevent headaches as well. Making sure that you drink plenty of water, staying hydrated. So my suggestion is drinking a gallon of a day of water, but being consistent. You can't make up for it in the middle of the day. You've got to start off the day with 16 to 22 ounces of water and be consistent. So again, as I stated at the beginning, keep a headache diary if you suffer from a lot of headaches. Track the foods that you're eating throughout the day and the time that you eat them, and see if maybe those headaches are correlating. Now, I didn't mention this, but I think this is really important to mention too. Managing your stress. Feeling tense or worried may be enough to make your headache come on, or your head throb, right? So make sure you integrate some regular exercise. This can give you a sense of control over your life and refresh yourself and put out all that frustration someplace that's positive. It'll also help you lose those extra pounds and keep a healthy weight. If this topic interests you and you want to learn more, I am hosting a 14-day cleanse. And because you are in Power Up Basic, if you are, hopefully you are, members in Power Up Basic, which is a community here on Facebook or a Facebook group, you get 20% off of this cleanse. So post a comment below with any questions that you have or private message me personally, Catherine Hood. Also, feel free to share this video. I would be so, so grateful. But share it with individuals or share it on your personal page or your group page, wherever you want to share it. I'd be so, so grateful. Anyways, thank you for tuning in. I look forward to being a part of your healthy lifestyle journey. And as always, I'm here to help you.